You might be forgiven for thinking that Vivaldi concentrated on instruments that you blow, like the bassoon or the recorder. But you'd be wrong. He wrote concertos for all sorts of other instruments too, including the mandolin, which looks a bit like a guitar, but has a more rounded wooden body. This is how it sounds playing Vivaldi's music alongside an orchestra. As you can hear, he wrote a huge number of different pieces of music. He wasn't one of those people who wandered around worrying about getting a tune right for days and days. Instead, he wrote pieces very speedily. One of his friends even claimed that Vivaldi could compose a brand new piece of music from scratch faster than someone else could copy out notes of a tune that he'd already written. He liked to travel around Europe and often took with him two young women, a singer, who'd been a pupil of his, Anna, and her sister, Paulina. Now, because Vivaldi was a priest, he was not allowed to get married, or even to have a girlfriend. But some people suspected that both Anna and Paulina were Vivaldi's girlfriends, and at the same time. It's no wonder that his bosses in the church became so cross with him. Vivaldi didn't seem to be that bothered, and there's no doubt that he was quite an arrogant man with a big ego, which didn't always make him that popular with the people who knew him. He became quite rich during his life, but by the time he died in 1741, his music had faded from popularity, and he was buried in an area of the graveyard reserved for people without any money. As you will hear later in our story, this happened to another of our famous composers too. Vivaldi's music only really started to be played regularly again in the middle of the 20th century, 200 years after he had died. This wasn't just a fluke of history either. Some time after he died, a nobleman called Count Giacomo Durazzo gathered up all Vivaldi's original works and kept them hidden from everyone. He left instructions for his family to ensure that none of this music by Vivaldi should ever be performed or published. Eventually, these instructions were overturned. But it was only about 80 years ago that many of Vivaldi's greatest works were heard by the public again. Quickly, they became very popular all over the world. Music historians spent a lot of time uncovering more details of Vivaldi's music. Of course, once they had discovered his music, they wanted to learn more about what he was like as a man. And that's when everyone found out about the priest with the red hair, who was also one of the naughtiest of all the famous composers.
Thank you.